Although a gym is considered a luxury in a home, it's something that more and more people are considering. And if you want to put a gym in your home, here's some tips and tricks to make sure that it not only works out, but it works out. That didn't work out. Let's try that again. Here's some tips and tricks to make sure that the room works out as well as you work out. Now, first of all, if you're building from scratch, soundproofing in the walls. I'd suggest it's fairly affordable, and if you're like me and you like to blast the music, it's not gonna disturb other people. Then when it comes to the drywall, use a Habito drywall. It's way more durable than a standard piece of drywall, so just in case those weights hit the wall, you're not gonna leave any dents or bumps in there. Now when it comes to the floors, again, you want durability. We're using a vinyl flooring on a dry barrier subfloor. So that means that the space can breathe underneath. It also insulates it so it's nice and warm on your feet. Lastly, ceiling height. You're gonna want at least 8 feet of ceiling height. Anything less than that, you could be compromising because you get up on a cardio machine like this, you're gonna be bumping your head on the ceiling. That explains some of the construction elements you wanna consider. But next, we're gonna talk about the layout of the room. If you want to get a good workout, you need to have a great layout. And so we're talking about this home gym and all the different pieces of equipment. You got to remember, a lot of these pieces of equipment can be from 4 to 7 feet long. Spacing them out appropriately is everything. Now you're probably going to have a couple cardio machines and you're going to keep them in one spot. And then you'll have your free weights and benches. Those will be in another spot. Keep a good distance between each item, but try to build it like a circuit. Also, keep a lot of floor area. A lot of people like to do floor work, and you have to be able to walk between the different machines. Now, when it comes to a seat like this, where you're probably gonna be doing a lot of bench press, a lot of freestyle stuff, you wanna make sure you're not too close to other pieces of equipment or the wall, because that's when you're gonna start hitting it. I could demonstrate, but you know, we've only got from 4 pounds up to 30 pounds, so the weights I would normally use aren't even here. But I gotta find some 2 pounders. So for now, I'll just start at 4. And you're gonna wanna make sure you can't hit anything with your arms. Full range of motion, no walls, no other equipment. Yeah, pretty good, pretty good. Ooh, this is good. I can feel the burn. Oh gosh, I don't wanna break a sweat. I really don't wanna break a sweat. I'm gonna put these back. Sometimes when you wanna work out, you just wanna take it up a notch. Or 4 notches. And it's amazing. There's so many different options that you have with technology and fitness. I mean, a lot of them are combined now. You can check your vitals, you can track your distance, all those things, which are pretty standard. But now you have the option to have built-in TVs, to attach to any of your wireless devices. This thing even has Bluetooth, so you can play your music while you're doing what you're doing. Wish it had oxygen. It has a fan. Can run a little fan here. Sometimes there's so many options, you don't even know what they all are. Like just numbers and stuff. I think this just says 10. 10 plus red, whatever that means. That means it speeds up a bit. The 10, no big deal. That's fast, actually. Right, so this, you know, make sure you know what they all mean before you start hitting them. That's actually pretty fast. I guess that's 10 miles an hour. No big deal. You know, there's a 2 here as well. Maybe we'll just hit that. Maybe we'll just hit that one for a second. Yeah. Faster, slow down faster. Okay. I wonder what this does. Oh, good. It's also got a built-in emergency stop. You know, just in case you're not fully up to speed with all the technology. And don't forget about the accessories. They can really take your workout to the next level. You know, a workout ball, some floor mats, resistance bands. Have a spot for all of these extra pieces of equipment. Also, think about storage. You're gonna want your towels, reading material, a glass of water, or even a radio. And last but not least, stay motivated. So have fun with the space. Maybe paint the walls a crazy color, put up a mirror, or even a whole wall of mirrors. You can see what you're doing. You can also tell if there's a whole production team in your gym. So who's gonna spot me next?
Me.
You're in? Let's do this.